Hi everyone, so this video is going to be a little question and answer video, and I'm going to be painting some vegetables because I realized, well, not all of them are vegetables, also some fruits and just like various kinds of food, but most of them are vegetables because I realized I never really draw food and I wanted to give it a try because you're gonna have to draw food eventually, so I didn't know what to talk about, like I had no idea what to talk about for this video, and I decided to do a question and answer because I recently hit 150k a couple weeks ago, and I thought it would just be like a good way to like allow you to ask some questions because I know there's a lot of new people here. So I'm just gonna go. I posted this 5 hours ago and there's 212 comments, so I wanted to try to answer all of them, but I clearly can't answer 212 questions, so I'm just gonna scroll through and pick out a couple that I want to answer. So something I've seen a lot of people ask is tips for starting an art YouTube channel, and I actually want to make a separate video for this, but basically the biggest tip I can give is to post consistently and try to make your videos as good quality as you can. Just make them nice and bright and clear, and try to use your voice or even your face, because the more engagement with you, the more people will find it interesting. And try to post regularly. Try to post like once a week or every other week. Once a week worked out really well for me, and I'm actually going to move on to twice a week once I have more time in the summer. But at least once a week, that would be my recommendation for like steadily growing your channel, I guess. But I want to make a whole other video about that, so I'm not going to talk about it too much. Someone asked, is mayonnaise an instrument? And I think it is. SpongeBob is probably one of my favorite cartoons, to be honest. It's so funny. What kind of music are you into? I never know how to describe this because, like, my favorite band is 21 Pilots. I think I've been a fan since, like, 2015? Yeah, 2015? 3 years ago? The summer of 2015? That's my favorite band. My absolute all-time favorite band, but there's other songs I really like and other bands. I used to love Mumford & Sons, but I've kind of over-listened to everything and I can't listen to them anymore, and I'm kind of not liking them as much as I used to. I really like Mother Mother and AJR, and I don't know, just anything that sounds like that, anything similar to that. And whenever I'm like, I have to write something, like if I'm working on homework, I'll put on just like those like chill playlists on YouTube, just because it's like relaxing to put on in the background. I don't know how to describe my music taste. I really don't. I like kind of more upbeat sort of songs, or like if it's a slow song, it has to be like really pretty. I don't know how to describe it. I'm sorry. What age did you start taking art seriously? I'd say I started to take it seriously when I made my YouTube channel, which was in 2013. That's when I started to like really consider art more, even though I was very much a beginner back then, but I still had it as a goal. Well, I had it as a goal my entire life, but I took it seriously once I started my YouTube channel. Do you ever get bored with drawing? Like, you know you can draw, you're just bored of doing it. How would you deal with that? I get bored a lot, and I think there's a difference between being bored and being burnt out, because boredom is something in art that I can overcome, because I'll just like think of something interesting that I want to draw, or I'll start drawing, and then an idea will kind of come from that, and like I'm still able to draw. Like, being bored, I just kind of try to think of something or just force myself to start drawing, and eventually I'm not bored, but it does happen a lot. But being burnt out is different. It's where you like you can't draw. You might want to draw and know what you want to draw, but you just can't, or you just can't think of any ideas, or your hand just physically hurts. So when I get bored, I just try to force myself to draw, because I know once I get started, it just kind of evolves from there. Like, the ideas just start coming. And having a sketchbook for that is, like, I do that in my sketchbook. That's what really helps. What's the most important thing for you when creating a piece of art that is pleasing to the eye, or that it tells a story? The most important thing for me, or the thing that usually makes me start to, like, the thing that kind of sparks me to want to draw is usually the concept behind it. And then from the idea, or from, like, the story or the concept, that's where the aesthetic comes in to make it pleasing to the eye. So it kind of starts with the idea, then the aesthetic. But sometimes you'll have a certain color scheme in mind, and then you build something around that. It can go both ways, I guess. What's your phone battery at right now? Okay, it's at 9%, and I'm reading your questions on it, so I hope it doesn't die. Why does your profile pic have blue hair? only because I just wanted to draw blue hair. I don't have blue hair. I have brown hair. I'm thinking if I ever change it, I'll change the hair color and change the color of the bird, but I'll keep it like the same sort of theme. Oh wow, I know why I have 212 questions. Some people ask so many questions. Are you an avid reader? I don't really read. How do you like your eggs? I like them over easy, I guess you'd say. I guess like medium. I can't remember the terminology. I used to know this. Over easy or over medium. I think over medium is when it's like slightly runny. I kind of like it that way. What time do you like to draw? I like to draw early in the morning and late at night. Those are like the two times of days where I find myself most productive. Do you like ketchup, mustard, or mayonnaise? You can only pick one. Ketchup. When are you going to show what's on your pencil case again? Oh yeah, I forgot. I made a video a while ago showing the stuff inside my pencil case and saying I was going to update every month, and I just decided to not do that anymore because I just thought it would be a bit excessive. But honestly, I think after this, like maybe in a couple months, I'll like show you what I use again. Or I'll like show you my art supplies again because I think I've definitely changed the stuff that I use. What's your favorite medium? Do you ever plan to stop doing YouTube? My favorite medium is digital art and then watercolor or gouache, actually, both of them. I plan to never stop doing YouTube, as long as YouTube is still a website or it's still like a good website. Like if something really bad happens to YouTube, then maybe I'll stop, but I don't plan on stopping YouTube anytime soon. What recording and editing software do you use? I use, to record my screen, I use OBS. And to edit, I use Adobe Premiere Elements. The intro? Someone asked how I made my intro. I just drew a bunch of different pictures and like made them fade onto each other to kind of make the different, like, to make the plants fade in and the bird fade in. I don't really animate things, so. What sketchbooks do you use for watercolor? I like to use mixed media sketchbooks, so either like the Canson XL or the Strathmore Vision. Those have worked really well for me for watercolor. It's not as good as like watercolor paper, but it's pretty good for a sketchbook, and they're not that expensive. What makes you so confident in your art, and how did you develop so well? I'm not confident in my art at all. I mean, maybe like to some degree, but honestly, like I don't really think any artist is that confident in themselves. You just have to kind of, I don't know. You just have to kind of try to not criticize yourself too much. Just try to accept that there's flaws in your art and just know that everyone's learning, like everyone is on a different path in their art and everyone is at a different level. But I don't really think any artist is confident in their art. It's normal to not be confident, so don't worry. Just try not to be too hard on yourself, pretty much. What was your dream job when you were younger? It was always to be an artist. Always. Bullet journals. Do you have them? Do you like them? I don't have one, but I like them. Oh wow, some of these questions are very creative. Are you ever going to do an animation? I think you'd be really good at it. Also, what drawing monitor do you use? I've never really done animation before, but I'm sure eventually one day I'll do something, like a little tiny, like 3 second thing or something, who knows. I use a Cintiq Companion to draw. And that is a lot of money and you don't need something that fancy. I just really liked the portability of it, so. Introvert or extrovert? Introvert. I am an introvert times 1,000. Some of you guys posted so many questions. Thank you. There's like so many. Can you describe high school in one word? Homework? Awkward? Either awkward or homework. I don't know which one. Have you ever played an instrument? Yeah, I play the flute. Not the recorder, like the flute. I know some people call the recorder a flute, but I play like the flute that goes horizontal, like the metal one, not the recorder. Summer heat or winter cold? I'd have to say summer heat because when it's cold, I can't do anything. Do you tie your shoes the right way, the best way? I don't know if that's a reference to something, but I keep my shoes tied and I just like slip them on and off every day. Can you see yourself as anything but an artist? I always thought it would be cool to work with animals or something to do with the weather or nature or like rocks, stuff like that. I'm kind of interested in. Like, I'd say a meteorologist, but I don't want to do the public speaking part of that. So just like the science behind that and not like the being on TV part. What's your favorite color? I like burgundy and really bright blue and like kind of like a bright teal blue. And I also like purple, but more of like a bluish light purple. Can this be the last question? Yes, it can. I hope you enjoyed this video. Just like hearing my answers to your questions. I really wish I could answer everyone, but there's 212 questions, like I said. So I hope I hope I picked some good ones to answer. In the future, any other future question and answers, I'll probably do the same thing. I'll just ask you for your questions and then I'll answer them. So I hope you found this interesting. I hope you enjoyed seeing me paint the little vegetables. It was a lot of fun and just kind of relaxing just to fill the page of some good food. And I will see you in my next video.